Good evening, gentlemen. Once again, my name is Cindy Beal, and I represent Payne and Meadows. Thank you for serving on this jury and for taking the time out of your busy lives to decide this important case. Now that we are at the end of this case, I want you to think about what this trial has been like for Payne and Meadows. Her child, Pat, has been in the hospital the entire time, and all Payne and Meadows had really thought about during this trial is whether her child, Pat, is going to be okay due to the negligence of Dalton Fisher. Negligence is the failure to take proper care in doing something. There are three elements in the duty. There are three elements: the duty, breach of that duty, and whether the breach of duty led to the injuries. The breach of duty is when one fails to fulfill his duty of care to act reasonable in some aspect. In the trial, you heard Dalton Fisher, who had the duty to do a fulfill check past curfew. The tape trick from Donna Hughes and Casey Damon is not the same as a fulfill room check to make sure each kid was in bed. When Pat was not feeling so well, he told Dalton Fisher, and his response to Pat was, "Find some food. Maybe someone else has some." As a teacher, you have a duty of care to take responsibility and help out the student. The duty of care is to take responsible care to avoid injury to a person. In this case, Dalton did not take his duty of care seriously, and he breached it. Pat took full responsibility to go to Dalton's room to tell him how much worse his sickness has gotten, but Dalton Fisher was not there. The plaintiff has the burden of proof by preponderance of the evidence that we hold. During our trial, you heard the school's future procedures, which clearly state that there must be one faculty member for every 15 students on the trip. Dalton was the only chaperone for 20 students. You heard from Bailey Thompson, who is in charge of the chaperone procedure. Bailey Thompson's response to school's policy was, "I understand the conference had a 20-to-1 policy, school policy, but the conference does not have the insurance and liability issues that a school district has. This shows how even though this hotel allowed the 20-to-1 student policy, it is still not a safe idea for the hotel to allow this. The procedures also stated that the chaperones must make arrangements with students to allow students to contact chaperones in emergency situations. Dalton failed to provide his contact information to the students. If Dalton allowed the students to order room service, eat at the hotel restaurant, or was there for Pat when he needed food, Pat would not be in the hospital now. Pat was smart enough to take full responsibility to go out with Avery Harris and find food. Even though the defense has shown documentary proof on Joint Exhibit 3, which shows Hot Dog Heaven is right next door to the hotel. But we don't have any proof if it was open during the time Pat and Avery left the hotel. I want you to remember that Avery said in her testimony that the fresh air helped Pat feel better. Walking a few extra blocks to the fast food place made Pat feel so much better, and all this kid wanted was to feel better. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to close your eyes and picture a young 17-year-old boy who is third to attend a school field trip as a birthday present. Pat has been through a lot recently with his parents' divorce, and his family is on a tight budget. But yet, this kid is working hard in school and starting to apply to college. This trip he attended would have helped him to get a scholarship. Now this kid is in a coma due to the negligence of Dalton Fisher in the Smithfield District. Could you imagine what you would feel like if you were Pat? Now Peyton is sitting here wondering if she can afford to pay for the hospital bill or Pat's injuries, and if Pat will become an okay, and if there will be enough money for her son to attend college. If you are parents, how would you feel if this was your child? And if you are not parents in this room, imagine this is happening to your niece, nephew, cousin. If you are not one of those, I want you to imagine yourself as a parent. Put yourself in Peyton's position today. We ask the jury to return a verdict in favor of the plaintiff and award money damages. Thank you.
Okay. All right.